For all the latest behind-the-scenes news from the world of professional wrestling, you must check out the WCW Hotline. A new message, updated every day until midnight Eastern tonight. Check out Chad Damiani's exclusive report at 1-900-909-9900. Mike Tenay, Larry Zbysko with you back on Thunder, and Larry, it was quite a shock this past Monday on Nitro to see the return of Bret Hart, and it's obvious there's just one thing, there's just one man on the mind of Bret Hart, and that's a match with Hulk Hogan. And as Bret said, it's about that he's waited for, it's about that he's dreamed about for years. Quite honestly, he won't come back, he can't come back unless he gets a fight with Hulk.
Yeah, that's understandable in a way, Mike. I mean, Bret Hart said he's been sitting around thinking a lot, maybe thinking too much, but still, every time he gets in an arena, every time he flies to a town, every time he gets inside that ring, he still has to be reminded of that very sad tragedy within his family. So for Bret Hart to come back, it's got to be everything or nothing at all.
And as Hulk Hogan has been accustomed through the years as the World Heavyweight Champion, they're coming at him from every angle. Hogan insists he was not the man driving the white Hummer. He had no clue why Randy Savage and Gorgeous George were in his locker room recently on Nitro. This past Monday, Hogan explained that he owns two Hummers, but that they don't fit the description of the vehicle that reportedly rammed the limo of Kevin Nash. And I think another question that we need answered, Larry, who attacked Sting when the lights went out in Hulk's locker room Monday night?
Well, I tell you what, talk about intrigue. I mean, we got Lex Luger pointing fingers at Hulk Hogan. We got Hogan pointing his finger back at Lex Luger. And don't forget, Bret Hart was in the room also.
He sure was. Bret Hart was in there. Hogan, Sting, and Luger. We saw the lights go out. The next thing we saw, Sting was on the floor. And then fingers began to be pointed. Blitzkrieg to go one-on-one with Van Hammer. And you see the huge power, size, and strength that Van Hammer has. And he exhibits it here in the opening minute of this matchup against the cruiserweight Blitzkrieg.
Well, Van Hammer, I mean, he's getting some education now. The guy's been around. He's starting to learn how to use his power. I mean, he's a massive man. He's starting to learn how to use his balance, use his power. Not the fastest guy around, but compared to Blitzkrieg, not too many guys are fast.
Among the quickest of all the wrestlers in World Championship Wrestling, and he's going to need to use that kind of a strategy if he's going to be successful against Van Hammer. He's not going to be able to out-muscle him.
You got stuck!
Van Hammer now going to take him around and just swing him around the ring, whirlybird style, and then crops him to the mat with a clothesline.
Dropped him. He flattened him.
Blitzkrieg is going to have to employ a hit-and-run offense if he's going to have any success against the big man Van Hammer, who blatantly chokes him, just throttling Blitzkrieg right in front of the referee, Charles Robinson.
Hey, he's going to have to try to get behind the guy. I mean, you're talking about everybody, you know, going after Hogan from all directions. Usually it's just a good stab in the back by your peers, but when you're the champion, you're going to get it from every direction.
In the corner, now Van Hammer takes Blitzkrieg, sets him up on the top turnbuckle.
All right.
And just, oh, look at that. He's just took him by the neck and peeled him out of the corner. What strength.
Yeah, he threw him all the way across the ring, and that's almost 20 feet.
Now follows up by dropping the leg right across the midsection for the cover. Gets two, and Blitzkrieg somehow able to get the shoulder up at the last second.
Well, I mean, a hand on the face isn't enough to hold his shoulders down. Blitzkrieg is still fighting for survival in there. Hammer's not giving him much room to recover, which is smart. These cruiserweights, they get their win back quick.
Van Hammer continues to put together the power move. He got it, the gorilla press slam, countered by Blitzkrieg. He got it down. Got two and off the roll up a two count only.
He got him down, just not enough size to keep him down.
Back to his feet. Drop kick momentarily rocked Van Hammer, sent him to the ring rope, attempted a spin kick. Van Hammer caught him in midair and threw him into the mat.
Spin kick, and he was too short to do that to Hammer. He couldn't get that leg up high enough to hit him in the chin or any place effective. Hammer just caught him again, but he stood there. He's learning how to use his balance.
The momentary offensive outburst from Blitzkrieg stopped Van Hammer for just a second, but he goes right back to the attack. Scoop and a slam, then drops the elbow. Gets two, and again, the nonchalant cover, not putting all the weight across Blitzkrieg, cost him that time.
But then he's still on the offense, though. He's not giving Blitzkrieg a chance to regroup, get his air back. He's hanging him out to dry here.
Front suplex dropped him stomach first across that top steel cable. Blitzkrieg in trouble, just hung out. Van Hammer now going to try and take him and take him up into the air with a suplex, and the vertical suplex brings him back into the ring. WCW Mayhem will take you where no wrestling video game ever has before. As you see, the countdown is on. 14 days, 3 hours, now under 30 minutes. You know, the people at Electronic Arts have really outdone themselves, Larry, with this project. WCW Mayhem in stores everywhere beginning September the 24th.
I hear the game, Mike, is just unbelievable. Technology has gone through the roof.
Really takes wrestling video games to another level. And speaking of another level, Van Hammer up to the middle rope. Nothing but canvas, maybe the opening that Blitzkrieg needs. Somersault through, standing moonsault, but he missed.
Hey, that was a heck of a move for a big man like Hammer to try, but when Blitzkrieg wasn't there, I mean, what a smack. That would have set off the Richter scale.
Now Van Hammer takes Blitzkrieg and picks him up, and again just throws him down. Variation there of a Beal. Blitzkrieg in trouble at this point.
Beal is throwing out garbage.
Going to take him up again. Another, well, Beal tosses. Look at the agility of Blitzkrieg. On his feet. Springboard at the middle rope.
In the face.
Drop kick delivered directly to the face of Van Hammer.
That's a bulldog.
For the cover. And 2-0. But you see there's still plenty of strength left in Van Hammer. He just Blitzkrieg on the pinfall attempt and tossed him through the ring ropes and out to the floor.
Yeah, hard to cover a guy this size for Blitzkrieg. I mean, Hammer probably uses dumbbells that way when Blitzkrieg does.
Now he takes Blitzkrieg, drives him back first into the ring apron, and then smartly rolls under the bottom rope to break the count from the referee. Now where's he going to send him? He sent him up to the ring apron. Look at the move by Blitzkrieg.
Hit him right in the head.
Moonsault back from the ring apron to the floor, connecting with Van Hammer, and now both men are down.
I tell you, if Blitzkrieg can get something going, he's going to have to use high-risk maneuver against this guy because normal maneuvers aren't going to make it.
Both men now back to their feet. Van Hammer in the ring. Shoulder block from the apron by Blitzkrieg. Springboard to the top. Flip for the crossbody. Caught him in midair and then drove him to the mat.
The leap of faith did not come true this time. Just too big of a man. Blitzkrieg took a chance here, but
Cobra clutch applied, and there's their slam.
I think the dice came up snake eyes.
Hook of the leg, shoulders are down, and the three count. Well, it was the power game of Van Hammer that allowed him to dominate this matchup against Blitzkrieg, and in the end, it was Van Hammer scoring an impressive victory here on Thunder, Larry.
Yeah, it was impressive. Blitzkrieg really never got a good chance to get going with some speed. When he tried to do, you know, what he can do, Hammer was too big, but again, he had balance, Mike, and the balance held him right in there where he threw Blitzkrieg just from pillar to post.
Thunder Replay brought to you by Wendy's Classic Hamburgers. It's Hamburger Blitz, and it's a victory for Van Hammer here on Thunder as he defeats Blitzkrieg with a Cobra Clutch Slam.